Hello, this is a video that is more of a tutorial for you on how to assign a grade. So that's the work that I need you to do for the grade meeting. You have to sit and go, okay, for goal one, I give myself a blank. And you do that for all three goals. So let's look at what this means and how you can do it with a little less nervousness, because it can be really strange. I understand that. So the thing to remember at all times is you are not just giving yourself a qualitative grade about how you're doing in English class, because that is very nerve-wracking. Instead, it's goal specific. So when you meet with me, you'll look at your goal and you'll say, based on my feedback to myself, which I'm tracking in my weekly document here, I think I am doing pretty good with this goal. Let's say it's developing better thesis statements. I started not really feeling very confident in my thesis statements. When I entered the course, I would give myself a B in this category. I understood what I was being asked to do, but I never felt like my thesis statements were very interesting. With practice, I've gotten better at this. In the last 2 weeks, each time I've had to develop a thesis statement, I felt really good about it, and it seems like I am developing mastery. So where do I give myself a grade? Well, the A, B, C, D metric is something you actually know really, really, really well. An A we consider to be work that is exemplary. You could help other students with this. You've understood the concept so well that you know how to succeed. A B is you need a little help from me or from somebody else. You can achieve with that support. It still feels like if you're left to your own devices, more often than not, you won't get to that high level of mastery. You'll only do it sometimes. And then a C is really, the word is middling, middle. You are not really succeeding, you're not really failing. Your performance is average. It's okay. You're not going to be helping anybody else with this because you don't even really fully understand it yourself, but you are trying, you are making an effort in the right direction, and once in a while you feel like you can even do it without support. Still, C represents an achievement that is not predictable. When you do succeed, it's almost surprising, or you are delighted to find that for a moment in time you understood it, but you don't exactly know how. And then a D is you're not really close. You aren't even trying that much. You're not even sure what it is you're meant to do. And you probably need some reteaching from me, where we meet and I say, let's talk about thesis statements. Do you know where that goes? Do you know what it's meant to be? And those conversations, you would go, okay, I think I can actually learn what this concept might be, but you're not really proficient at practicing it yourself. And then an NA is, I don't know, we haven't written a single thesis statement. So that wouldn't be true, right? Because we have written a lot. All right, so you know this, but then how do you give yourself a grade? And if I know you guys, a lot of you are going to grade yourself lower than I would. So if you are, in the example I just gave, struggling with thesis statement, or you were, but now you feel like you're getting it, like the last 2 weeks, you've known what to do, you've set out to do it, and you've achieved it. That suggests to me a kind of mastery. You are able to predict for yourself success in this world, in this concept, whatever it might be, thesis statements. That is an A. Of course, it's really personal, and your evidence might be that 3 weeks of it you didn't do great, and 2 weeks of it you did, and you have to decide. Where does that put me? How do I feel about the success that I'm tracking? And that is where you and I will just talk, and I will help you from my objective perspective to probably lift you. I think maybe in some cases I might need to be a little bit more real talk with the fact that you're not achieving, but more often than not, it's going to be me trying to cheerlead you from some of the successes I've seen. Don't be afraid to give yourself a B. Knowing that you actually have a lot of room to grow and that you have every intention of growing and getting the A you desire. And don't even feel afraid to give yourself a C or a D if you just know not even close to this thing. So that is my advice. The other thing I'll offer that should really help you, and I'll go back to my document, you might need to develop more specific goals. As you go through and you assess yourself, you might find that your goal is so big, it's actually impossible to achieve complete mastery. If your goal is have amazing ideas, well, what would that even look like? So you might find this is a good opportunity to go to your goals and eliminate one of these sub-goals or tighten it up so it's something that you can really see yourself achieving. Maybe not right now, but something you can see yourself achieving by the next time we sit to meet. They're a little frightening, I understand. They're a little strange. We've never done anything like this in school, probably at this point for you. So sign up for the quick meetings. I promise I'll make you feel a little better. And that the remember above all, this is a snapshot of where you are right now with these goals, and it will and should change.